Bennett, please step forward. The court finds that both of these killings were indeed heinous, atrocious, and cruel, in that they were extremely wicked, shockingly evil, vile, and the product of a design to inflict a high degree of pain and utter indifference to human life. This court, independent of, but in agreement with, the advisory sentence rendered by the jury, does hereby impose the death penalty upon the defendant, Theodore Robert Bundy.
Everybody,
take care of yourself, young man.
Thank you.
I say that to you sincerely. Take care of yourself. It's a tragedy for this court to see it's such a total waste, I think, of humanity that I've experienced in this court. You're a bright young man. You made a good lawyer. I'd love to have you practice in front of me, but you went another way, partner. Take care of yourself. I don't have any animosity to you. I want you to know that.
And you end up probably in some kind of domestic, ultimately hit him in the head so hard with a pan that you actually cave in the front of his skull, and then you stabbed him no less than 12 times. And you know what? I was the only one in the courtroom that knew what kind of knife that was. And it was a big old long fillet knife. Because I used it to fillet pike and muskie and salmon. And I'll tell you, you gutted him like a fish in that apartment too. You were relentless. You stabbed, you stabbed, you stabbed, you stabbed, you stabbed until he was dead. You didn't think he was an intruder. You know, maybe one stab wound, okay. Maybe that's seven defense. But you put in 11 more to make sure he was good and dead. So I agree with the family. I hope you die in prison as well. You know, and if this was a death penalty state, you'd be getting the chair.